Good morning. My name is Tamara Swan. I'm the Distance Education Coordinator for the Bagley College of Engineering, and we'd like to share a little information with you today about our online bachelor's degree in electrical engineering. And I'm going to let the faculty and staff that help with that degree introduce themselves now.
Good morning. I am Dr. Jean Mohammadi Arak. I am an associate professor in electrical and computer engineering, and I am the undergraduate studies coordinator for the department.
I am Kylie Crosland. I am the program coordinator for our undergraduate electrical engineering degree program.
Hi, my name is Allison Stamps, and I am an academic coordinator within the department here as well.
Thank you all so much for joining us. As this program has come online in the last couple of semesters, we've had some questions come up, so we're just going to take a few minutes and answer those questions for our potential students. So could someone tell us a little bit about the undergraduate electrical engineering program as a program of study for future jobs?
Absolutely, I'll take that. The exciting thing about electrical engineering is that you can do anything that you want. So if you think about, you know, all the electronics that are around you, your cell phone that's in your pocket, the computer that you're watching this video on, but even other things like medical devices or transportation, like the systems that help airplanes fly or systems that deliver clean water, everything about us is run by electricity, computers, and some types of electronics. And as an electrical engineer, you'll learn all the fundamentals and theoretical knowledge that you need in order to design these systems, to sustain these systems, and to create new systems that we don't even know what they might be.
That sounds pretty exciting, and it sounds like they're going to be learning a lot. So can someone tell us a little bit about the program of study and what type of classes the students will take?
Sure. We have 128 credit hours that are part of the undergraduate degree program, and it's a combination. We have our core curriculum that's required of all students, so it would include your composition, 3 credit hours of fine art, humanities, social sciences. But then on top of that, we have math and science courses that are required as part of that. But then we also have our engineering topics that are broken down. And as part of the engineering topics that are broken down, we offer those online in a rotation. And those actually begin in the fall. So if you start the online program in the fall, you would be enrolled in our Intro to ECE Design 1 as part of that. Of course, you can still join us in the spring and we'll pick up that rotation on the next go round. But what we try to do is we try to balance those engineering topics with the other math, science, and core curriculum classes that need to be taken online.
Can somebody tell us a little bit about labs? I'm assuming since this is a high STEM degree that there's going to be some lab work.
Absolutely. So we do have quite a few labs in our curriculum, and those labs are in the electrical and computer engineering courses are fully online. So as a student in the online program, you do not pay lab fees. That the lab fees are used to sustain the labs here on Starkville campus for the Starkville students. Instead, you will buy your own equipment and your own devices that you need. So one of the big costs is going to be purchasing a personal oscilloscope. And right now we're requiring the Analog Discovery 2. It is several hundred dollars, but it can be used in all of the labs that you'll take. Additionally, some of the labs will have some parts that you purchase, such as an Arduino microcontroller or some resistors and capacitors. And all of those lab devices, parts, things like that are listed on the website, so you can kind of see what the cost is going to be and know that you're not paying the lab fees. In exchange, you're buying these devices for your own use. And when you're finished with the program, some of the things like the Analog Discovery do have resale value, so you might be able to sell that to a new incoming student or another online site in order to recoup some of your cost.
Well, that sounds good. So Allison told us that there's 128 hours. Can student get all of those from Mississippi State? And what will those classes look like if they're taking them here at Mississippi State?
Taking classes at Mississippi State through the online program will be offered through Canvas, our learning management program. So that's where students will access all of their course material. They'll turn in their deliverables through Canvas, be able to watch videos, and have discussion boards with fellow students. There are a few courses that Mississippi State currently does not offer online. Those are listed on the Center for Distance Education's online MS State website. We can help students find options that could meet those criteria through a local community college close to where they are. We want to ensure that students will take courses that will transfer into Mississippi State as what they want it to be. So we are more than happy to help students find what will transfer as what they want it to be.
Great. If I'm interested in participating in this program and I've watched this video, I've talked to y'all, I've been online. So where do I go? What is my first step in seeking admission to this program?
So your first step is to apply to Mississippi State. The Bagley College of Engineering does have a set of admission criteria. Those are listed on Bagley's website. So if you are not eligible to start in the program because you don't meet those criteria, then you can start as an undecided or undeclared student while still taking coursework towards the program. Once you have applied to the program, you can also fill out our scholarship application to see if you are eligible for any of Mississippi State University's scholarships.
All right, so I've been admitted to the program and I'm looking forward to my first set of classes. What's the process for getting registered for classes?
The Center for Distance Education office does have an online orientation. After you complete that online orientation module, then they do let me know that you have completed that process. After that is complete, then you are able to contact me and we can talk about classes and be released to register for classes. We do registration in October and November for the spring term, and then we have registration for the summer and fall terms will be in March and April. So that's kind of the best times to get into classes. Of course, with our online classes, students are able to get into those as we near closer to term. But you do need to complete the online orientation and then we're able to release you for registration. Also important is to send all of your transcripts. If you've taken any college work, credit work before entering our program, you want to send all of those transcripts to Mississippi State with your admission application so that those can be reviewed and evaluated for applicability to the program.
If I'm interested in applying, can I just send you all of my information and you tell me what I need to do, or do I need to apply first?
You would have to apply first because those transcripts do have to be evaluated first by our registrar's office.
We're looking at the EEST website at online.msstate.edu, and it provides the basic information for students interested in applying for this degree. They can get information on tuition and fees, schedules, the application link is here. Students can request information. It gives us a little information about what EE students can expect, but then as we scroll down, these are some of the things that y'all were talking about. The degree requirements, talking about transfer credit, program structure, the core curriculum that Allison mentioned. All of the required courses are listed here for students to review that as well. The course rotation that was mentioned is listed here, and then the admission process. New admission students, you have all the details here, and then information that Kylie listed about the academic advising. As we are wrapping this up, does anyone have anything that they want to share?
One of the questions that gets asked is whether our program is ABET accredited, and if you're going to the online website for ABET and you're looking at online programs, you'll notice that MSU's electrical engineering program is not listed on the ABET website. That's for several reasons. The primary one is that our program is not a fully online program. So some of our courses, like the chemistry, physics, and math courses, are not offered online within the program, and you have to take those maybe elsewhere. But do be reassured that our undergraduate electrical engineering program is ABET accredited. We're offering the same courses that we offer to our on-campus students online. We're working with ABET. We go through that process and we're in contact with them, and we are looking into whether we could in the future have a fully online program accredited through ABET. Part of that will also require having a graduate before we can go through that process. So I hope that that adds a little bit of clarity and relieves some of the concerns if you go to that online website on ABET's side and see that we're not listed there.
I appreciate y'all's time today and look forward to seeing what's going to happen with this new degree program. And of course, we showed Kylie's contact information on the website if anybody is interested in reaching out to her. Again, my name is Tamara Swan. I'm the distance education coordinator for the whole college. I can help as well. And we hope that this short video helps you as you get ready to continue your college education.